Next, questions about the safety and future of nuclear energy in the wake of the Fukushima reactor disaster in Japan. That's the subject of tonight's Frontline. NewsHour science correspondent Miles O'Brien traveled to three continents to find the answers. Here in the United States, he looked at the Indian Point power plant in Buchanan, New York. One of the reactors there was shut down last week for repairs, the 18th unplanned shutdown in 5 years. Here's a portion of Miles's piece.
A Fukushima-scale accident here, less than 50 miles from the lower tip of Manhattan, would likely mark the end of the U.S. nuclear industry. 17 million people live within 50 miles of this plant. And that's one reason plant operator Entergy's application for a 20-year renewal is proving so controversial.
You're looking at unit 3.
The company says it spent $1 billion on upgrades, and that an accident of the scale of Fukushima couldn't happen here.
The problem in Japan was they weren't able to cool the reactors. We have 6 sources of off-site power. We have 3 emergency diesel generators on both units. But I have 2 more redundant emergency diesel generators. Either one's capable of safely shutting down a unit. They're located at 4 different elevations, 4 different areas of the plant. Some are in bunkers you were in. One's elevated at least 40 feet above where the water is.
This is a contentious license renewal, the most contentious I think we can agree on, right? Why?
Well, we're in a metropolitan area. When the plant was built back in the 60s, because Unit 1 was actually commercial in 1961, there was people that didn't want it here then. But we are a valuable asset to the community here in many ways. In the air quality, we're a low-cost provider of electricity. Therefore, we hold the price of electricity down in the area. And in fact, if you look at our life extension, if we operated 20 more years, just the union labor would earn over $1.3 billion in earnings at today's salary.
The plant has its passionate critics.
We've had some earthquakes in the eastern and central U.S. Right. So
Lynn Sykes, a Columbia University geologist, has spent years arguing that the Indian Point plant is not fully prepared for earthquakes. 2 seismic fault zones intersect 1 mile north of the plant.
All right, so the Ramapo Fault, which you discovered, where's Indian Point?
Indian Point is right here.
Right on the fault. When they were designing Indian Point, this was unknown.
This was unknown. The original design for Indian Point 1 barely mentions earthquakes, except to say that this region is quiet compared to Alaska and California and Japan. Which is true.
If they were designing the plant today, says Sykes, the NRC would certainly take into account the newly discovered seismic data.
Let's start with the earthquake and paint the series of sequences that worry you that could lead to a loss of water and lead to that release of radioactive material.
Right. So one would be if the reactors themselves are damaged by an earthquake that is large enough to crack critical components of that system.
That would be a pretty big quake, wouldn't it?
Well, that could be a magnitude 6. If you have an earthquake that is very close to Indian Point, it doesn't take as large an earthquake to cause damage, and particularly if it's shallow.
And yet you still live here.
I still live here. I live 17 miles from Indian Point.
How much concern does that give you?
It gives me a fair amount of concern, and one of the reasons is that Indian Point is closer to more people than any other reactor in the country.
Not all experts agree with Lynn Sykes. Other geologists claim the Ramapo Fault is not seismically active, and Entergy insists Indian Point could handle a magnitude 7 quake.
The fuel that is in there is all the fuel that Unit 3 has ever used in the course of its history?
Yep, since 1976.
So you're full?
This pool is basically full. We have an application pending with the NRC to begin.
Nonetheless, with all this radioactive material on site, Sykes' work raises an important question. If a powerful earthquake triggered a series of unforeseen events leading to a release of radiation, like Fukushima, how would so many people make their way to safety?
Nuclear aftershocks can be seen on PBS's Frontline tonight. Check your local listings for times.